My name is Engineer Ololade. We are trying to carry out some serious provision of a generator that will not make use of fuel at all. Either PMS, which some people refer to as petrol, or diesel rather. What we are combining here is a serious engineering trade that has something to do with an alternator, has something to do with what people refer to as a DC motor. DC motor, people refer to it as a direct current, which this is a practical example, and it has two terminals. It has the positive and the negative output. This DC motor has the capacity to generate 12 volts. This DC motor cannot practically be used for an alternating current. You know what I mean by alternating current? It's a voltage that has something to do with, say, about 240 volts, between 200 to 240 volts. But this one can only give us 12 volts. And that is the reason why we are using this to couple our alternator. These are practical combinations of the alternator. All these simple generator, this simple and better pass my neighbor generator can be used to combine this practical experiment. What we are having here is what they refer to as stator winding. The stator winding has serious output. It has the AC output, in which the red wire gives us the positive terminal, while the black wire gives us the negative terminal. We have this that was colored as yellow, and it has something to do with the capacitor. You have to connect this to the capacitor. If you don't connect a capacitor to this winding, you won't be able to have your 220 to 240 volts from the alternator. And this one serves as a charging system. These green cables can be used to connect the battery, because we are going to use battery. We are going to use 12 volts battery to tally with the 12 volts DC motor that we are using. This can be connected to our diode, and from the diode you have your supply directly to the battery, which is 12 volts battery. It can be 45 volts, 45 amps, it can be 60 amps, it can be 90 amps, it can be 120 amps battery, as long as the battery capacity is 12 volts. You must make sure that the battery capacity corresponds to the capacity of the DC motor, the direct current motor. This is the stator winding. I have explained that. This is what we refer to as armature. Some people call it rotor. A lot of roadside electricians call it armature. This armature, with supply from the DC motor to the stator winding, immediately you pass this current into this, there will be interaction between the field that has been created in the stator winding and the armature. The armature will be rotating. Will be rotating inside the stator winding. Magnetic field will be created between this coil and the coil of the armature, thereby bringing out an energy. The energy may come in form of DC, it can come in form of an alternating current. It depends on the capacity of the alternator. Now, what we commonly use in Nigeria is the system of alternating current, which is from 220 to 240 volts. And if we are able to produce a DC with the combination of an alternator, and it gives us a result of 220 to 240 volts, that means the area of using fuel would be off completely, because the battery will serve as a fueling station. Fueling station from the battery to the DC motor, from DC motor coupled to the alternator through the aid of this pulley. We decided to cut this from this mechanical aspect of a generator. Some people call it shaft of the piston and ring. So we cut this off from this. The same thing happens to this. We cut this off from this also, so that we can weld this inner part that goes directly into this DC machine, to DC motor, like this. It will enter here, and it goes directly into the alternator. So that gives us the combination of the DC motor and the alternator. Let us go into the process of coupling. System one, placement of the shaft coupling. Place your stator winding, and you make sure that you arrange those cables to tally with the output slot here. There is a slot here. Make sure that the arrangement of the cable that is going out is properly placed like this. This is the armature. Don't forget, this slot here is going into that shaft. Look at this. The shaft that we remove from the piston and ring of the mechanical aspect of that alternator. We cut the shaft from this end here. That is what we are having here. That means this slot here is going indirectly into that shaft slot. This bolt is going indirectly to the shaft. Don't forget that the shaft has a screw slot. The head here is a screwed head. You can see this bolt now, it's a screwed end. You insert, it goes directly, you tighten. You take your spanner, it can be ring, it can be flat, as long as the spanner is, this nut is 12 now. So you tighten. That means, don't forget, we still need to put some nuts here before this thing can be properly hold. Before the thing can hold properly. Because the thing must not vibrate. It must not pull out under working condition. When you put on the DC coupled to the alternator, it must not pull out under working condition. Those are the processes. Make sure you retighten this thing. There is a slot here. That slot must enter the slot of this housing. You see, some people, some layman, they prefer marking. That's what you refer to as marking. You see them doing some marking in some area. They will mark like this. They will mark. Then they will come and mark the bottom. So if they are assembling, this mark must correspond to the mark of the armature, and it must correspond to the lower part of the cover. So if you mark, you know where you remove the signs. It goes like this. It comes like this. It goes like this. Even that is, if you cannot even remember this slot, you must be able to remember that you have marked your parts, your basic parts, part A, part B, part C, you label them. So when you are coupling, it will be easier for you, those areas that you have marked, to couple them together. Invariably, you have 100% efficiency in the alternator. But if you carry out a wrong coupling, the thing will not even function at all. Bolt one. Here. We have bolt two.
You see, they will not make a mistake. Definitely, they know this thing is very long. So there is a slot for it to go in. And it goes in directly like that. The third area is here. You know this place is free. It's quite different from this place. The boat will go in like that. That is reassembling of the alternator. Don't forget, you could discover that this thing is moving here. It's going in, coming out. We are going to aid the stability of this shaft with the connection of the DC motor with the aid of an Allen screw here. That is the next step we are going now, coupling of a DC motor to the alternator. This DC motor is serving the same principle of operation as this alternator, because what we are having here is stator winding also and a rotor. And some people refer to it as armature also. They are using the same principle. It is the interaction between the stator winding and the armature winding that will bring out that 12 volts we are talking. Now we are going to couple this armature, the shaft of this armature, to the shaft of this alternator. And you must make sure that there is a screw head here that you can easily unscrew. You can unscrew it like this so that it can take the slot of this shaft here, the shaft of the DC motor. You saw there is a slot here. This screw here will go into this slot. So we are putting this in now. Make sure you set it properly, so that the shaft of this DC motor will not pull out under working condition. See, this is the screw I'm talking, and this is the slot, the shaft slot here. Make sure it goes in directly. With the aid of your Allen key. Allen key is very cheap. 200 naira, 300 naira, you can buy Allen key, and make sure you use correct tools so that there won't be any deficiency in your coupling system. This Allen head type of screw in mounting this DC motor to this alternator, this DC motor will pull out when the thing is rotating. That is the reason why you see us guiding this DC motor with the alternator with the aid of this Allen screw. There is a horizontal system of placement. You see, this one is diagonal. Look at this one. It goes in directly to the slot of the alternator. This one is going in directly to the slot of this alternator. You see, there is an improvised hole here, because this won't be able to tally if we put it now. It's free. So we have to cut in a slot here so that it can go in directly to the slot of the alternator. Another Allen head. Don't worry, we are having other stand. As I've explained initially, this is an improvised stand with the aid of the two-legged rubber legs of the alternator, of that whole generator. Don't forget, I said we are converting that, I better pass my neighbor generator, into a fuel-less generator. Now you know it has four stands, four legs. This is the first two legs, one, two. These are the other two legs. It serves as a stand for the DC motor. You can go to any welder to construct this for you. Make sure that what they are constructing tallies to the capacity of the DC motor, to the framework of the DC motor you are using. For example, we are taking this area as our standing point now. And this, you can easily adjust with the aid of this button nut. You can unscrew. Then you place it here. Make sure you tighten back, because this DC motor will be vibrating with the alternator, and if you don't tighten back the bolt head, this thing will be pulling out. That is under working condition to be pulling out. We are not having a stand-up fuel-less generator. We are moving. We are leaving the coupling aspect of this generator now. We are moving to the wiring aspect of this fuel-less generator. As I've explained, we are having output. Don't forget that the windings of the alternator is categorized into three different areas. This is the AC output that you will run to your input, to the input of the building. Generator, NEPA. If you are changing from NEPA to generator, to fuel-less generator this time, not ordinary generator, fuel-less generator, a generator that doesn't use fuel at all, you change from NEPA to fuel-less generator. This will go in there directly. Red implies positive. Black implies negative. So where you are having your L and N, or neutral, you are running this to that place. Don't forget, we are going to connect our capacitor into it. And there is an output for capacitor. There is an output for your charging system. Here now, it doesn't have any terminal identification. You see some, it has, you see them labeling them positive, labeling others negative. You see the sign of negative. You see the sign of positive. That will tell you that this red wire will go to positive, or the other one will go to negative. But this is a capacitor. What is a capacitor? They use capacitor to store energy. The energy that will come out of this alternator is going to be stored here before you can have your full voltage of between 220 volts to 240 volts. You connect. You have different capacity of this capacitor. Mainly, they are all 220 to 240 volts. But you see some, you see them, they put 20 microfarad. You see them putting 15 microfarad, 30 microfarad. Don't forget that the alternator you are using has an inbuilt capacitor like this, which is always 24 microfarad, and it must tally to the speed of that alternator. You see some alternator are 2000 N, the speed. The speed of that alternator is 2000. The speed of that DC motor must be able to be higher than the speed of that alternator. Because immediately you put load on the alternator, it draws energy, it consumes power. You see, when you put load on your, I better pass my neighbor. Immediately you put on your television, before the thing stabilizes, that television will consume energy, then it stabilizes. The same thing happens to DC motor and alternator. The capacity of that DC motor must be a little bit higher than the capacity of that alternator. You see some 2000 Newton. That is the speed. the DC motor, if the alternator is 2000 Newton, the speed of the DC motor must be higher, either 2500 or 3000 Newton. Make sure that the capacity is 12 volts if you are using 12 volts battery. It's only the rate of the speed of the DC motor must be higher than the speed of the alternator. Now, I've explained this capacitor. So you see it now, it has been written. They put in 24 microfarad. That is the capacity of this capacitor. Some are 20, some are 15. It depends on the load of that alternator, the winding system of that alternator, that will determine the capacity of the capacitor you are putting into it. Normally, you don't need to change the capacitor if you move. So maybe somebody that is selling them generator now. And you cannot use a condemned alternator. If the alternator is burned, it won't work. So if you want to do it at all, you can go to generator man, you purchase an alternator. You can purchase a complete generator. Dismantle the mechanical aspect, it should be left with the alternator aspect. And the alternator aspect must function properly. So that is it, that is the capacitor. The one that I really recommend is the one that has been installed to that alternator itself. Because they have rated the winding of that alternator before they put in this capacitor. The other time I said we are having three outputs from the alternator windings. This one goes directly to the capacitor. This one goes directly to the load. We refer to load as, we refer to the building as load, because we are going to put the whole building on this line. So we refer to it as load. Red is for positive, black is for negative. So this one goes to the building. Generator NEPA, NEPA generator. This one goes to that side. This one goes directly to the diode. You know what we explained the other time is recycling of energy. We are recycling energy from the alternator back to that battery. This battery gave us the initial power. It gave us the initial energy. That is 12 volts to the 12 volts DC motor. From DC motor, it goes directly to the alternator, where the alternator brings out 240 volts. And we want this battery to be fully charged always. So we need to recycle the energy back to the battery through the system of charging. That is the reason why we are connecting this diode, so that the alternator can charge the battery back. It is these terminals that we will connect to the diode. These two cables, these two green cables, we are going to connect them to this diode. Then you look for a very safe place where you can mount your diode. Here, we will reserve this screw head for the mounting of this diode. So we are connecting now. This is just rough connection. You are supposed to use a clip. So there won't be any bridging of cables. There won't be any negative contact between the similar posts of cable here. So that is the doubt. Then this one will go directly to the battery, battery terminal. Don't forget, I explained that we have different capacity of battery. This one is 12 volts. There is 24 volts battery. If your DC motor is 50 volts, 40 volts, 60 volts, 100 volts, you must make sure that the capacity of that battery tallies to the capacity of your DC motor. But the capacity of DC motor now is just 12 volts. So we are supplying it with 12 volts battery. Forget about either it is 12 volts, 60 amps, 12 volts, 70 amps, 12 volts, 80 amps, or 90 amps or 120 amps. That is just capacity building. This is red. Make sure that red goes directly to the positive terminal. And black goes directly to the negative terminal. This is negative, and this is positive. You can see positive terminal, you can see negative terminal. So it goes directly like this. So in essence, this DC motor is 12 volts. This battery is 12 volts. The capacity of this DC motor must tally to the capacity of the battery. There is what we refer to as motor speed. That is the rate of movement of the motor itself. Some local people refer to it as RPM, revolution per minute. That is the rate of movement from 0 to 1. 0 to 1, that is RPM. They call it revolution per minute. If the thing moves like that, the movement in 1 minute is revolution per minute. But you know, it has a unit. Don't let us go into the unit, the basic electricity unit. Let's forget that. Let us talk in terms of layman. That is the RPM. Now, this must definitely have an input. It cannot roll itself and roll the alternator. Definitely there must be a power supply. That power supply, it is this 12 volts battery. Now, if you have to differentiate, you refer to as what we call color code. Red is for positive. Let it go directly to the battery positive. This is black. Let it go directly to the black terminal of the battery. Black to negative, red to positive. Don't forget to return the charging system back to it and clip it on the top. Clip black to negative terminal. Now, it's giving us two supply now, positive, negative. Those two terminals, and we're having DC input. We have one terminal here, we have the other terminal here. This is the other terminal. Now, as I've explained, we are having three different outputs from the alternator windings. One of the outputs is to load. That is, the installation you are supplying is what we refer to as load. And that will cover this output. Red for positive terminal of your load, black to negative terminal of your load. Now, we are assuming we are using this extension box as a load output. We refer to this as an extension box. This will cover our load now. You connect red cable of your load to red cable of the output of the alternator. You connect red to positive. You connect black to black cable of the alternator. Just like this. And make sure you insulate your cables. Wherever you are making joint, always insulate your joint. Insulation in the essence, you must tape. Every naked wire must be taped. Because if you don't tape, then there will be leakage and it can cause death to whoever that is doing the connection or whoever that want to use the fuel-less generator. Now you have connected your load. This is your load. The other one goes directly to the capacitor. The other two yellow output goes to the capacitor. While the two green output cable goes to the diode. Don't forget that the diode will recharge. Through the diode, you recharge your battery back. Now, charging system. Positive to positive. Negative to negative. Now, we are connecting negative terminal of the battery to the negative terminal of the DC motor. Don't forget, always connect all your positive first. Don't connect negative, so that you won't have direct load input at the same time. Now we are connecting, and there must be means of starting and stopping, either a switch or an isolator. Isolator may be small switch there. It may be main switch, on and off. It may be just ordinary switch, so that you can just connect your positive terminal to the switch or the isolator before you run it directly to the DC motor, so that you can easily go there, put it on. Easily go there, put it off. That means of isolation, we cater for that area. Now connect. There is an output now. Now, this lighting point serves as means of load. This extension box, you can connect your television, you can connect your fan, you can connect whatever. You can even run this one directly to your changeover switch. Or I better pass my neighbor, generator, NEPA, NEPA generator. Now, instead of putting generator that is using petrol, you can put fuel-less generator there, then put NEPA. Just remove your plug and plug your fuel-less generator there. There will be output. There must be means of charging. There must be means of recharging the battery back. If you don't charge back the battery, the battery, the energy of the battery will go down quickly. Within 5 minutes, you will consume the energy on the battery. Now, means of charging is put this down. You can easily test if your alternator is charging the battery back. Through this means, you can see that the thing is sparking. That means there is a return of energy back to the battery there. The television serves as a load. So that television derives its energy or its means of supply through this fuel-less generator via this extension box, then down to the generator. That is the main principle of this fuel-less generator. You can connect this output directly to your main switch or your changeover. Benefit of those people who cannot speak English. So we want to translate it to Yoruba. In that answer, in that sense, we have said die ni pa generator wata answer ni ti o lo epo rara fun anfani awon ti o le so yinbo la ye tun so ele. In that bi se generator wa yi ti o lo epo o lo petrol ko lo diesel awon kan ta fi se ni alternator ati nkan ta npe ni DC motor. DC o tumo si pe direct current motor. Gbogbo ala mo pe generator I better pass my neighbor ni gbogbo awon nkan ta awon eyan lo ju. Generator I better pass my neighbor e na la fi se practical aspect of ise ta se. O ni alternator. Alternator e nkan meji lo ni. O ni nkan ta npe ni stator winding. O tun ni nkan ta npe ni armature. Méjèèjì yẹn tó wà nínú ọ̀tàlẹ́tọ̀ yẹn náà ló tún wà nínú DC motor. Nínú DC motor yẹn, ó ní stator winding, ó tún ní nǹkan náà pè ní armature. Méjèèjì la so papọ̀ tó fi da fuel-less generator wa, generator tí ò lo epo rárá. Kóró ni pé a ṣe nígbà tá a dismantle small generator yìí, I better pass my neighbor. Ibẹ̀ láti yọ shaft yìí. Shaft yìí la gé. Tá lọ jómọ́ pẹ̀lú DC motor yẹn. Nígbà tá a jómọ́ tán, làwa rọ̀ ọ̀nà ẹ̀dá rẹ̀ lọ sínú alternator. Nígbà tá a rọ̀ ọ̀nà ẹ̀ lọ alternator, boat kan wa boat yen ogun on la fi de lati nu alternator yen ta fi de won papo bo je pe shaft yen o raye stay oni ma lo so waju ko ma lo seyin ko ma lo so waju ko ma lo seyin la fi de won papo a to wa lo nkan na npe ni allen screw head on la fi de DC motor mo lo alternator yen papo a lo meji fun ikan loke kan sale a se so that oni ma gban to ba vibrate this yen ayo jade this motor ayo jade ta don na ayo jade so a dismantle die ni da ji de meji papo alternator yen o de tun ni awon kan tan pe ni oni output meta lo ni and wire bi orisi meta lo gbona jade nbe ikan lo a connect kan lo si ori capacitor ti aba ti o ba ni capacitor nu a ni le ri 240 volts ego ni le gbona jade so yen ni nu running winding a n pe ni running winding nu stator winding yen won run ni meji jade yellow o na connect ori capacitor meji ba connect ori down yen o lo charge battery yen pada battery yen 12 volts o lo gbona supply instead of fuel tan da petrol si generator ma start de ewa petrol petrol ba ti tan generator ma ask ask stop ise but battery only source of supply wa si DC motor yen and to ba de ye pe ta ba charge DC motor yen pada ami battery pada o ma gbe na lo o ma ko di ni le do ba di consume energy to wa lori battery DC motor yen ma ku pa de fe ko ma se be yen tori yen la se work means of charging and when it means of charging that the work we doubt the evil so doubt the evil when we supply to all the alternator so there be green wire maybe that connect my doubt the so the guys are running that's doubt the solid battery so I'm a charge here most here do not turn on that net nobody can consume now really battery without the I'm a charge battery but so it's a you know that when you continuous process me from DC motor to alternator from alternator to doubt from down to battery get from battery again onupa lo sori DC motor wire yin o tuku kan mo salaye meji yellow meji o lo sori capacitor green meji o lo sori dad to charge battery yen o wa ku meji kan le dad ka di black kan ni lo lo sori eru o lo lo sinu ile a ma npe ni load won lo ma gbe na lo directly sori lo sinu ile a ma n ṣàlàyé ẹ pé I better pass my neighbor o ma n ní ibidán tí ma n yọ plug from NEPA to generator eléyìí ló ma connect directly lọ sí ibẹ̀ yẹn sórí plug yẹn tó a chain from NEPA to generator so load yìí ló lọ bẹ̀ nǹkan tá a fi represent yẹn mi báyìí ní extension box yìí extension box serve as load gbogbo inú ilé wa ó lè jẹ́ load extension box yìí load ni irú extension box yìí láti run supply lọ sórí television ẹ lè standing fan yìí ẹ lè gbé sórí ẹ àṣìṣe ẹ lè connect gbogbo eléyìí 2 bedroom 3 bedroom ẹ lè connect ẹ sórí àṣìṣe ẹ bá gbàgbé pé alternator ó póríṣiríṣi ó depend lé agbára nǹkan tẹ bá fẹ́ fi gbé alternator eléyìí ó kéré àwọn alternator mi wà tó tóbi délé lọ ẹ̀rọ àwọn mìíràn lè ní 1 kva wọ́n lè ní 1.5 kva 2 kva 3 kva 4 kva ó depend lé agbára alternator yẹn winding àwọn coils àfi ṣe winding ẹ lòun ló máa ń dictate kva or 2.5 3 kva or 4 kva alternator so lóò tó bá fẹ́ gbé ìwọ́n tó bá mọ̀ pé o fẹ́ gbé 3 bedroom flat or a duplex ó ti mọ̀ pé o lè lo small generator fún dámì pé nǹkan tó máa build ó gbúdọ̀ jẹ́ ńlá alternator ńlá ló máa lọ lò fún wàá dẹ̀ wo capacity alternator yẹn o ló máa fi supply pẹ̀lú DC motor yẹn processes yìí o la wa pè ní fuelless generator ó dẹ̀ wà iṣẹ́ tó máa ń ṣe ó pọ̀ gan nínú ilé pé bóyá pé generator eléyìí ò lè gbé fan méjì ìrọ̀ ni ó lè gbé fan minimum of 4-5 fans ó lè gbé lighting circuit bíi mẹ́rin bíi márùn-ún gbẹ̀gbẹ́ lè ṣe wáyé kò lè gbé fridge kò lè lè gbé air condition so tí wọ́n bá fẹ́ increase yẹn tí wọ́n bá fẹ́ fi gbogbo yẹn ẹ lọ ra bigger alternator ẹ dẹ̀ make sure pé
capacity your talent o tali pelu capacity dc motor te fe cup mo processing ta wa pe ni wireless generator ni gege bi addition la tele ti o se se te ba deji idi wireless generator yi elle fait pouje en comment chiche a chiche a ro be do le ma gbe na jade en lo si idi capacitor ke lo boost capacitor yin o ke change ko mi be ti o ba tan ko mi ko capacitor yin di baje elle ni capacitor meji meta sinu le te ba fi mi si a chiche mi le te ba di boost te ba ma da yin pada sibe a chiche pada e boost a gbe na jade lo sele si tole de common fault tole sele te ba ni rina lori ninu le yin ni e ko si kan je yan lo ti o ba je doubt na ni le ba ni mo pe ba ti on charge mo lo si di doubt e ko lo wo doubt ko change doubt je ni le ni ba ti ma charge pada so en ga da wa pe ni ti wa ni fuelless generator ni e de mo pe anfani e po gan ko si ba gbe en lo le epo en re e lo cube epo le 3-3-4 liters lojojumo ko si pe awon ara adugo ko si ba pe o pariwo ninu ile po ba tan be to ma paro horo gbogbo ile aji ko si yen be eleyi ko pariwo kankan ju running system alternator te ma gbo o de ariwo e na o to ti generator te pe o ni kana din pe salenza o ni gbogbo e ariwo o je ko simi tori pe a n fe eleyi se demonstration fun awon e pe o le sise nkan ta se nkan ta build to n sise ni labi lo se wa bayin eyan le package e to je pe e le se sinu small container ni e ma lo meta e se sinu small kekan housing kekere fun ke gbe sinu e ke package e gbogbo kini wa wa nu e nkan ta kan ma se output lasere kan ma run jade lo to je pe a je wa simple inu box yen kan le gbe battery e gbe sinu e e package e sinu e be output lasere kan ma ri. So, ko ni si ba pe ba je ri bayi tori pe a ma demonstrate fun awon eyan a ma salaye ke bo awon eyan le to je ri bayi ta ba se bayi ko ni ri awon eyan so e to awon eyan si ni lati package e